Hey, what's up? Welcome to a new quick edit video. Again, this time I want to work on a car light trails image. That means I will be combining multiple images, but before that I'm doing some basic raw adjustments inside of Lightroom and then later switch to Photoshop to merge all those images. So before I start with the editing, let's first take a look at the before and after images. Alright, here we are in Lightroom. You can see this one is the main image I want to work on. And down there you can see all the other images in which there are some car light trails. So let's start by working on the main image. First I'm going to the Lens Correction tab real quick and activate those two settings. Then let's go back to the top. And for this picture I want to apply a rather dark style with a little less contrast than there is right now. So let's start by reducing the contrast, and therefore I'm choosing the Adobe Standard camera profile. Then for the white balance, let's slightly increase the temperature. And then let's start by dropping the highlights to get back some detail from the clouds. Okay, now I can further reduce the contrast by increasing the shadows. And let's see, I could increase the white some more to brighten up the image. Okay, I think I need to darken the overall image a little bit, so let's drop the exposure. Now this will just help make those car light trails a little more visible. Then I also want to add some texture just to give everything some more sharpness. And let's also increase the clarity slightly. Okay, nice. I think we could use some more saturation, so let's increase the vibrance. But at the same time, I want to drop the saturation, just because I think it looks good with increased vibrance and dropped saturation. Alright, nice. Then let's do some local adjustments. I'm starting with the gradiated filters, and as you can see there is much going on in this image. First let's work on the sky. I want to darken the top part of the image, so here let's drop the exposure quite a bit. And let's also drop the texture, which will make this area a lot smoother. And then we could add some noise reduction as well. Alright, nice. And let's work on the foreground. For this grass here, I want to have some more detail and punch, so let's increase the clarity. And that should work quite good. Nice. Then I have another gradiated filter for the foreground. For this area, let's drop the whites to make this darker, to not lose detail in the darkest spots. And to further reduce the contrast, I'm increasing the blacks. Then I think the color tone of this area is a bit too warm, so let's drop the temperature. Okay, and then we have this gradiated filter left, and I want to use this one to add some kind of haziness to the image. And that's simply done by dropping the dehaze. And now watch what happens. Now you can see this will look like this road is lying inside of a cloud with some subtle fog, and I think this works pretty good here. Still, the negative dehaze made this area a bit too bright, so let's drop the highlights. Okay, nice. Then let's switch to the radial filters, and I have applied two of those to add some glow to the sky. And as usual, I'm doing this by increasing the blacks. And in this case, I could even increase the whites. And this looks pretty nice already. So let's do the same thing on this radial filter. Increase the blacks, increase the whites. And we are done. Maybe drop the dehaze a bit, but that's it. So then let's do some color grading. I'm starting in the Hue tab. For this shot, I don't like those green tones. I want them to be a little more on the blue side, so let's boost the green hue. And we could even boost the aqua hue to further increase this effect. And you can see we get this nice bluish color tone over the whole image. Then in the saturation tab, I'm dropping the green saturation as well as the yellow saturation. And instead I'm boosting the blue saturation some more. Alright, nice. And for the split toning, of course for the shadows I want to apply a cold color tone. And maybe let's drop the strength. Okay. And then for the highlights, let's apply a warm color tone here. Okay, nice. Of course I'm going to sharpen the image. And that's it for the editing of the base image. Now, since I have multiple images which I'm combining later in Photoshop, I want to synchronize the settings from this one to all the other ones. So I'm simply selecting all the images I want to combine. I'm holding down the control key and just click on those thumbnails. And then I'm hitting the synchronize button and synchronize. In the end, I changed the images of those car light trails a little bit, just so those car light trails are a little more visible. So now I want to open the images. Again, I'm selecting them all and then right click on one of the thumbnails and go to edit in and open as layers in Photoshop. Alright, first let's get rid of some of those sensor spots. In the base image, here I'm using the spot healing brush and then just paint over them real quick. Okay. Then right now in the layers panel, our base image is at the very top and we need to change that, so let's drag it all the way down. Now here you can see our car light trails images, which I'm going to turn off for now. And to blend those shots together, it's pretty simple. I'm activating this layer right here, then change the blending mode from normal to lighten. And this way we have added the car light trail. Of course, if you take a closer look to the sky, there are some unwanted changes, but that's not a big deal. I'm simply applying a layer mask right here. I'm holding down the Alt key and click this little icon, so the layer mask is automatically filled with black. Then I'm grabbing the brush tool and I'm setting the foreground color to white. And now I'm painting over the area where the car light trails are. And this way I'm adding the car light trails without adding any unwanted changes. And this step will be repeated until I'm done with all those layers. So activate the layer, change blending mode, add the inverted layer mask and paint over the area with the car light trails. Done. And I continue until I'm finished here. Alright, that looks pretty awesome. And let's clean up the layers a little bit. I'm selecting all the car light trails layers and just hit the browser icon to group them up. Now I could adjust them some more by applying a brightness contrast adjustment layer by holding down the Alt key and clicking between those two. I'm clipping this brightness and contrast adjustment layer to this group. Now if I increase the brightness, only the car light trails layers will be affected by it. Now of course you can see the adjustment layer is coming through right here a little bit. That's not a problem. I'm just using the layer mask of the adjustment layer and with the black foreground color I'm brushing out this effect. And then I want to add a subtle glow effect to the image. So I'm creating a new layer and switch the blending mode to hard light. Then I'm grabbing the brush tool and drop the brush opacity to roughly 10%. Now I'm holding down the Alt key and click in the area where I want to apply the glow effect, and this way I can pick up the exact color tone from there. And then let's just paint in some glow. Actually, I think this doesn't look that good here, so let's get rid of this layer, but I want to enhance the light of the car some more. So again, I'm applying a new layer, and again, I'm using hard light as the blending mode. And then I'm picking up the color from those yellow car lights. Let's make it a little more saturated. Okay, and then let's see. And now, before I start to overdo this edit, I'm stopping at this point. So I hope this was interesting and helpful. Of course, if you have any questions regarding the editing, then please let me know in the comments, and thank you very much for watching this video.